What is up, everybody? Jordan here. Thank you for stopping by the channel once again. Today, I kind of wanted to just go over my mindset and just some ways that you can step outside of the box and how to be more creative in your own kind of personal style. Of course, this is going to be different for everybody. These are just some things that, you know, go through my mind, some things that I incorporated into my wardrobe and my style, and you know how it's kind of developed and worked its way around and in the world. So I have three things that at least I could come up with right now that I can remember, that I can think of, that have really helped me kind of push the boundaries and just be more creative and really kind of get on that stepping stone to reaching my full potential when it comes to my style. It's always gonna evolve into something different anyways, but there's always gonna be that base layer. So that's a good segue into point number one, which is finding that base that you can really resonate with. Whether that be suits, if you're just into the more traditional, sartorial, classic way that people wear clothes, or if you're into that more classy streetwear look, if you're into that more just straight up vintage by itself, there's always that kind of little base thing that people revolve their style around. And once you have that, what you do, or what I've done at least, is find the little things that you see that you kind of gravitate towards the most, and how can you level that up? A good example is for people who have a lot of sneakers, and they wear sneakers with their suits, and they wear sneakers with their streetwear outfits, or they wear sneakers with their, you know, whatever it may be, classy, more minimal outfits. A good way to level that up, to kind of bolster your style, is to introduce different types of shoes in your wardrobe, whether it be loafers, whether it be brogues, or whether it be boots. Trust me, when I was younger, boots aren't what they are today. But when I was younger, I tried a pair of boots from Aldo. I remember this. I tried them on. I was like, man, I look stupid. And I never wore them again for years. And now the majority of my wardrobe revolves around boots because I think they're just sexy. I think they go with all my outfits, and they just really resonate with my style. So that's just an example for you guys. Second thing is another aspect of my style that I never used to wear in the past ever, actually. And this is more recent, and that is jewelry. Now, it doesn't have to be jewelry, but starting small is a good way to incorporate different things that might be outside of your comfort zone, or just kind of switching things up to your overall outfit that makes it look a lot better. And jewelry just so happens to be one of those things. It could be just accessories in general, but for this, it's jewelry. So when I first met Carlos back in, I don't know, 2013, 2014, whatever it is now, it's been a while, I just didn't believe in jewelry. I was just a bare bone, naked fingers kind of guy. I thought rings looked stupid on me. I hated the way necklaces looked on me. I did not like the way bracelets looked on me. But, you know, as time went on, I kind of just started to think of things and think of ways to incorporate them slowly. And now, you know, I look like, you know, Thanos sometimes with all the rings on my fingers, and I want them to be covered everywhere. So maybe experimenting with jewelry and trying small things on your fingers or your wrists or your neck. I mean, I never ever in my life liked necklaces. I still kind of don't, but for some reason, I mean, who would have thought I would be wearing a pearl necklace? Like, that's usually not a thing that people go out of the way just to find. But starting with jewelry, starting with something small, can really kind of help you boost your confidence in doing something that you might not have thought of in the past, but also at the same time making your outfits look super dope and kind of just elevating them at, you know, with your confidence. So it's like a, you know, killing two birds with one stone. Number three, we just have in general, stepping out of your comfort zone, getting out of that box that you put yourself into, and trying something new. You will be pleasantly surprised with the results. Sometimes you won't like it, and you'll be like, okay, that's not for me. I don't want to do that. But most of the time, if it's something that's in your mind that you like, generally speaking, you're probably going to like it once you wear it. So, I mean, another example for me is mesh t-shirts where you could like straight up see your nipple, or just like you can see your skin underneath. I never in a million years thought that I would wear that. Like, you know, I just didn't think that was gonna be part of my style. However, when I did that Harry Styles video, I fell in love with that type of shirt. So you know, if you wear it as like a layering piece the way that I do, you can get away with trying something out that is a little outside of your box, like a mesh see-through shirt. That's just for me. And last but not least, I think I said three in the beginning, we're gonna go with a fourth right here, is just finding your inspiration. Inspiration comes from everywhere, whether it be Pinterest, whether it be an Instagram model, whether it be just a movie star, whether it be something in a magazine. You know, it can be, or from a time era, from the 1920s, 30s, 40s, 60s. There's so many things that you can find in these different parts of inspiration in your life that you can incorporate into your style. And that in and of itself is going to not only give you your own style DNA, but it's gonna help you kind of break that mold and step outside of your comfort zone and just really experiment with different things in your style. And with all those things kind of put together, that is a good foundation to kind of get out there and do something new for yourself. Try something different with your style, like for that Harry Styles, no pun intended, video that I did. Like that, all that stuff there was new to me. Like it was different, but it made me feel so cool. I felt so confident in it. You know what I mean? Like it was a weird kind of like, I've never done it before, but I loved it so much once I did it kind of thing. So with these four things, that's kind of like how I've experimented with my style, how it's kind of grown and shifted and molded and, you know, been into this whole coagulation of what it is. But yeah, man, that is what I think helps when it comes to, you know, experimenting with style, or, you know, how to get out there and do something different for your style. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope it gave a little bit of inspiration. I hope it gave a little bit of help. And yeah, I'll be talking to you guys soon with another video. All right, bye. Thank you.